Microsoft Edge just got a full AI upgrade, and it's smarter than ever. It remembers what you were researching days ago. It compares all your open tabs and can even order things for you online. Hi, I'm Kevin, and today I teamed up with Microsoft to show you the top 5 new AI features in Edge. Let's dive in. Let's kick things off with one of my favorites. Copilot Actions. This is where Edge helps do tasks for you. Here I am on the self-declared world-famous Kevin Cookie Company website, and I like to bake some cookies. In the top right-hand corner, let's hover over recipes, and this one looks good, Clippy's Scrumptious Cookies. Leave a comment down below if you love Clippy. I'd love to bake these, but to be honest, I don't think I have all these ingredients at home. So, normally, I'd either have to drive to the grocery store or open Instacart and add each one manually. But watch this. In the top right-hand corner, let's click on the Copilot icon. And right here in the prompt field, I'll type in order all the ingredients for this recipe on Instacart. And then let's send that through. Now check this out. Copilot read the recipe, and now it's going through Instacart, it's finding every single ingredient, and then it's adding them straight to my cart. It does this all automatically, although Copilot will still ask me to confirm my order, and then I need to click on checkout. And just like that, my browser basically just did my grocery shopping for me. Now, let's close Copilot right up here, and let's jump into the cart just to make sure that it did everything properly. And here, I see all the different ingredients for Cookie's Scrumptious Cookies. Now, I could go ahead and check out, or I could ask Copilot to check out on my behalf. This saved me a ton of time, and it's not just limited to recipes. You can also ask Copilot to book, let's say, a dinner reservation, maybe clean up your inbox, or even plan a weekend getaway. That sounds fun. Let's move on to feature number 2, multi-tab context. This is where Edge can think across all the tabs that I have open. After ordering all of the ingredients, I realized my old mixer might not survive another batch of Clippy's Scrumptious Cookies. So I opened up a few different tabs. Here I have one for a KitchenAid mixer, also one for Cuisinart, and another one for Kitchen in a Box mixer. Normally, I'd have to jump between each page, read all the specs, and then figure out which one has the best reviews for cookie dough. But now, let's try asking Copilot. So right up on top, let's once again click on the Copilot icon. And over here, we could start a new chat by clicking on this icon, and here I'll type in my prompt. Compare my open tabs and tell me which mixer is best for baking cookies. And then let's send that. And look at this. Right up on top, let's pin the Copilot window, and here we could also expand it just so we could see it a little bit better. And look at this. It pulls together a comparison for all of these different mixers. It pulls things like the motor power, the bowl capacity, the speed settings. If we go down a little bit, here it compares the price across each option. It also comes up with what it thinks is the best overall for baking cookies, and it says it's the KitchenAid. Now, I've been eyeing that one, and I think it's probably good. But we also have the best value pick and also a budget-friendly option. So there, it pulls together all the main metrics that I care about in one easy-to-read table. This will make choosing a mixer so much easier. Here's another neat thing that you could do. Down below, I could also ask additional follow-up questions. As an example, I don't like when mixers make too much noise. So let's find out which one's the quietest and see if Copilot can figure that out for us. Oh wow, and look at that. Here it pulls out the estimated noise level for each model in those 3 different tabs that I was comparing. Cool. Let's try asking one more. I'd like to know which one has the best long-term reviews. The worst thing is when your mixer dies partway through a batch of cookies. Let's see what it comes back with. And here, just like we've been seeing, it pulls out and scans all the different tabs and gives me all of the key details. It looks like the KitchenAid has the best long-term performance. Now, honestly, this saves me so much time. I don't have to jump between all these different tabs anymore. Edge simply does the comparison for me. That way, I can get back to what matters most, which for me is baking cookies. You can also compare specific tabs. So I think I've narrowed my choice down to just the KitchenAid and the Cuisinart. If I want to ask additional questions about these mixers, down below I could type in the @ symbol, and here I could specify which tabs I want Copilot to base its answers on. So here I could select the KitchenAid, let me click here again, and then I could select the Cuisinart, and I have these 2 tabs selected. Right here, I could click on update tabs. Now, any additional questions or prompts that I enter here, Copilot will base its response just on those tabs that I have selected. Feature number three, journeys. When I open a new tab and give permission, Edge actually remembers what I was working on. Here on a new tab page, right at the bottom, you'll see that it automatically groups my past browsing into these little cards that you see right here. For example, there's my Montana outdoor adventure journey. That's from when I was planning a trip from Seattle to Whitefish, Montana. I've been looking at trains, hotels, and things to do around Glacier National Park. Now, next to that, I've also been looking for Halloween decorations for my house. Clearly, some very important research. And another one for the kitchen mixer purchase that we looked at earlier. Now, let's click into the Montana outdoor adventure journey. Edge opens up this page, and this is where it gets really impressive. It shows me everything I was researching for my trip. I see things like airplanes, hotels, restaurants, and things to do around Glacier National Park. Copilot summarizes all of it for me, the itinerary, the timing, and the top recommendations. And right down here, if we scroll all the way to the bottom, it even includes some pro tips for late 2025 travel. Now, the best part, I didn't have to save any of this manually. Edge recognizes the pattern in my browsing and it built this journey automatically. At the bottom, I can even open up the exact tabs that I had open. Here, I'll click on Show All, and here I see where it bases all of this information on. I'll close out of this window. Now, if I have additional questions, right down below, I can prompt Copilot. Overall, I think this plan is good, but I'll probably have some edits I'd like to make. So right over here, I could also click on edit in a page, and then I could make it my own by editing any of the content here, and I could also continue asking Copilot questions over on the right-hand side. Let's move on to feature number four, the new tab page in Copilot. This is the new search bar in Edge, and it's way smarter than before. Instead of just searching the web, it understands what you're trying to do and figures out the best way to help, whether that happens to be searching, chatting with Copilot, or maybe navigating to a site. So here as an example, if I type in best places to stay in Whitefish, here, I'll send that through, and it decides that a regular web search is best, and here it shows me all the different results. Let's go back and let's try another one. Here, I'll type in, what's the best time of the year to visit Whitefish? Now, it knows that's a question for Copilot, and here it automatically switches into chat mode. Let's go back again. Right over here, we have this dropdown. If I want to go deeper, I can choose a specific mode. So here we have a quick response, we could think deeper, and here we also have smart, where it decides what's the best. That way, I can choose how much reasoning I want Copilot to use. So it doesn't just wait for you to search, it actually understands your intent and helps get you there faster. Let's wrap up with feature number five, quick assist and Copilot vision. These features are so cool. To open up quick assist, in the top right-hand corner, you could click on the Copilot icon, but here's an even quicker way. And I love my shortcut keys. Simply press Alt-C on your keyboard, and that also opens it up. Now here, I've got one of my recent YouTube videos open, and I can just ask Copilot about what's on my screen. So right over here, let's click on Summarize this video. And then let's click on Continue. Copilot reads the page, it scans the transcript, and it gives me a quick summary of all the key points from the video. That is pretty cool. Down at the very bottom, I can continue asking more questions about the content on the screen. But we could take it even further using something called Copilot Vision. In the bottom right-hand corner, you can click on this microphone icon and you can actually talk to Copilot about the content on the screen. This one is crazy. Let's test it out. Hey, Copilot. I'm on a YouTube video and I was hoping you could help me understand the sentiment of all these different comments.
Sure thing, Kevin. The comments are a mixed bag. Some users are excited and appreciative, calling the features impressive and game-changing.
Now that is so impressive. Copilot analyzes what it sees on the screen, and then it tells me whether the responses are mostly positive, mixed, or critical. And all of that happens in real time. All right, that's a quick look at what's new in Microsoft Edge with Copilot Mode. Now, if you want to try it yourself, just check out the link right down below in the description or the pinned comment down below. I think that's Instacart with my groceries. So please consider subscribing and I'll see you in the next one.